Mike, you're up next in Upper Michigan, as promised, on 9:40 a.m. Hello, Mike.
Hi.
Go ahead, Mike. What's your question?
I was just wondering why in, I guess, media, they, instead of, you know, they always use the word gay and not, you know, like, just call it homosexuality. Mm-hmm. And I was just wondering, you know, you're supposed to hate the sin and love the sinner.
Yes.
But it always seems like they use that against people that of faith. That they're, I mean, I know there's some people of faith that make it sound like we're out to hurt other people, but...
Yeah, or Mike, that we don't believe the phrase. We actually
right.
mean hate the sin and the sinner.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
And I was just wondering what your take is on that and why, I mean, they push back so much at us for it.
So why use the phrase gay as opposed to homosexual? Is that what
right.
you mean, Mike?
Okay. You know, well, it's the act. You hate the act.
Sure.
You don't Mike, hate the person.
Yeah. Mike, I think you're asking a very important question about language and the power of language to persuade.
Sure.
You will not find the terms gay and lesbian in any Catholic magisterial document. It's not in the Bible. Why is that? Well, gay is a political identity marker.
Right.
We talk about people with same-sex attractions. As Christians, we're not interested in categorizing people based on their sexual desires. People are complex. People have their own histories. It's very unique. And Chuck, the love that we as Catholics have for evidence is shown in the fact that we don't tag people. We don't reduce
That's
them
right.
to their sexual desires. There's no proof that anyone's born this way.
No, not at all. And even the professional organizations, the American Psychiatric and Psychological Associations, which are pretty darn liberal on these issues, have come out with pretty clear statements that say, we don't know what causes people to be gay, and that most experts feel there may be a biological component, but there appears to be a developmental component. The word gay itself is an acronym for good as you, and of course, we don't think any one person is necessarily better than anyone else in God's eyes. But the reason why we don't use the term gay is because, as Patrick said, it's really a political statement, and people who say they want to adopt a gay identity are usually making a statement they're going to be pursuing a certain type of mm-hmm. agenda. And the thing to keep in mind is, you know, this terminology is all relatively new. There was no such thing as sexual orientation prior to 1973 when the American Psychiatric and Psychological Associations delisted homosexuality as disorder from the Diagnostic Statistical Manual, which lists disorders. So they've come up with this social construct that there's different types of sexual orientations. The last I've heard, Google lists like over 30 that you can identify
Facebook?
With.
Yeah. Facebook gives you 51 gender choices.
Unbelievable.
Sounds like an Onion parody, right?
It's absolutely ridiculous. Prior to 73, everybody was basically looked at as heterosexual, although some people would engage in homosexual acts. It wasn't looked at as something you're born with and can't change.
If you want the story behind the story of that 1973 flip-flop and the political nature of it, I can't recommend Robert Riley's book more highly. It's called Making Gay Okay. I interviewed Mr. Riley in 2014 on May 12th. Making Gay Okay can be heard at catholic.com/radio. Just look it up there, Monday, May 12th, 2014.